That's fair.
Look, that gas station exploded after Fletch thought he'd, like, turned off the pumps.
Yeah, I hit the safety, and it still exploded.
What bullshit is that?
What bullshit?
Okay. I'm assuming I know the answer to this question, but it's going to be Trusty Tony cannot make it. Yeah, I'm not going to answer it. This is too stupid even for Trusty Tony.
Okay.
Neither the forklift nor the Japanese car can pull this.
But what if I mix them together?
A Japanese forklift?
Look, there's not an engine powerful enough, and you can't combine their engines.
You need at least 20 mechanic skill to put two engines in one vehicle.
So if I start now, I'll have some by a long time.
Never.
Never, ever. Anyways, moving on. We definitely need to get a cab.
We need utility vehicles.
We need, yeah, stuff.
And we actually have a car to be able to go scouting for them now.
So you want me to go drive my car around? Eh? Eh?
Mm-hmm. Yes, we need to go drive and find more vehicles.
Alright, hop in.
We need, like... I would assume for the amount of work we do around here, just building shit, a couple pickup trucks would be nice. Some kind of utility vehicle for hauling, or like towing things. We need a tanker full of gas.
Keep the dream alive.
Well, I mean, we have the basics here. We have somewhere to stay, but we need things to make larger projects possible.
Yeah, but hey, I think we should work about getting, you know, a cab to the tanker. Yeah. I mean, those things... You saw, when you were doing the thing, you saw the tanks,
right? Oh, sure,
I
saw some inside the town. We can't drive in there. I mean, look
like,
at what we
like
ran into.
To maneuver
into just...
in there with driving skill is going to be a minus 10 penalty.
Look, yeah, look how often, as soon as we got on a road, we ended up being stopped. I mean, you left your sports car back there because of that.
Don't talk about that.
And if, in, you know, a minus 10 penalty to the roll, and that results in failure, you're looking at crashing with all of the consequences therein.
And we don't have any more children's helmets to protect us.
And that Japanese import's not going to be able to bulldoze past, like, you know, blockades and shit.
Okay, I have an idea. This is probably not going to do anything because people are probably going to pick the clean. But I'm assuming along Interstate 70 over here, there's probably some truck stops. Maybe there's a few cabs just happened, you know, to be there in one of these truck stops that still has gas in it.
There could be a truck stop, but that's a pretty small distance covered inside a an area that's fairly populated with towns.
Yes.
Crash actually comes up with this idea. He suggests, what about we get one of the school buses?
I like it. I actually do.
The school bus?
From where?
The high school.
Any of the towns nearby?
The Artesia one. Wasn't its parking lot empty?
No. Frederick.
I like it even more. Give this man a raise.
Like Riggs is like looking, and he's not sure whether the idea is too stupid or...
Man has just always wanted to drive a school bus.
It's not impossible.
Jack says, it's not impossible. We would have to lift it out of the crash. Yes, of course, but at least it would have like greater strength, and it could call more of us, and we could do more things, like actually push past zombies. And we could even make it into like a massive battle wagon and have it loaded to the tits with spikes and all sorts of other monstrosities.
Yes. Yes.
I think I saw this movie and it didn't end well.
Shut up. I like where this is going. Tell me more.
I mean,
look at your. I'm sure you could think of all sorts of cool armor plating and other sorts of wonderful things to put on that. It could be like a way to like raid other towns and pile all sorts of food and ammo.
That does it.
On
we're doing it.
Take it away.
He had me. It's gonna be our raider wagon.
Or battle wagon.
Riggs continues to remain like too stupefied.
All aboard the war truck.
But to do that, we need to go back out there to the high school and get a helicopter. Not a helicopter, a bus. Uh-huh. In the helicopter.
Versus, well, look, we obviously have to go back there anyway. We need hoses. And true. We're obviously going to need something else to pull the tanker at least a bit. Maybe the bus can do that?
I don't even know.
Zane, look, you're crazy. There's no way.
I don't remember my school bus as a child being that powerful.
With that and the Japanese import car and the forklift?
What, are we just going to daisy chain them together?
Why not?
Yes.
Staring at him with the same look Riggs is now.
I vote for this plan.
No plan.
I have no problem with going to the high school because food.
Yeah,
there are survivors there, and yeah, ammo is kind of an issue for dealing with the zombies.
Jack says ammo is kind of an issue for dealing with survivors.
Yeah.
Besides, and Jax looks at Crash, there's no telling how, whether any of them are possibly even remotely, like, driving it. Crash, look, Trusty Tony's obviously got that car working, right? He could get a bus working.
Yeah, there's, like, a complete auto shop in town that I forgot to conveniently tell you people about.
See? What do you think he found the car? Trusty Tony knows how to do things.
Yeah, I don't know how, hey.
Apparently, like, not tell us about stuff.
No one asked.
It's like, hey, wait. Oh, yes, I do.
Hey, I mean, Alfonso, Ray, Pink, Missy, they all knew. They didn't tell you either. Come on. The blame's not just on mine. Just my mind, man.
I'm surprised Ray just isn't on.
Why do I get the feeling you said something to the effect of like, "Don't tell anyone."
I don't remember.
Uh huh.
Physically,
that's
I don't
the
remember.
Best defense.
Doesn't remember.
Ray does pipe up and say, "Hey, look, a school bus battle cart would be incredibly bitchin'. We'd be able to handle a lot of zombies that way."
Yeah, I'm just not sure about the going and getting that part.
Well, looking at this year map, how Frederick High School is pretty deep within Frederick, so it'd still be a pain in the ass to drive it out.
It was very close to where we were, and we saw what the situation was there.
Yeah.
I was like, if it was on more on the outskirts.
The high school was the closest building to where you guys were at the gas station, and that's what happened.
Yeah,
okay, I assume the closer we get to the center of town, probably the worst it's going to be.
Mm-hmm. You're still looking at least for a fire department, rather, to get the hoses to actually siphon out the liquid. And, you know, that's still feasible to do. Without a cab, you could siphon out all of that wonderful flammable stuff. Just pour it into the grass right here.
Yeah, right here.
Right there.
We'll slowly push it around so that we cover all the grass and the entire.
You gotta prepare it for farmland, right?
Yes. Prepare it for farmland.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Gotta make it go fallow for 30 years.
Yes. If you make the field go fallow. I think Aaron disconnected.
No, I'm still here.
No. Someone disconnected.
It's Ryan.
Ta-da.
Conversation got just too stupid for him.
If y'all want to go to the school, we can go to the school. It's just things. We're back in a hard spot, is all.
I think we need to go to the school anyways. If it's just to go there and talk to people, like, hey, do you have any of the X? We have some X. Maybe we can trade
bullets. Oh God,
we could trade you X for X.
Ace will say, "I don't like the idea of trying to deal with those other survivors. They're going to die anyway. And once the zombies disperse after they die, we can go in and loot what they had. It's a much safer option than dealing with people who might have guns."
Yeah, especially in our current situation of not really having guns.
I would, you know, Ace continues to speak, I would prefer we just go in, get whatever materials that we need to make this irrigation possible,
mm-hmm.
and then we leave Frederick alone for a time.
Yeah, the water thing is still our goal at the moment.
Okay. So...
It crashes, but the bus could, like, and Ace says, no.
The bus will still be there.
Crashes, like...
Like... We can either drive or fly around and look for a bus. Or, Jesus Christ, a cab.
I have 130... Well... Boonesboro was fucked up. We haven't actually... Yeah, I don't know if we want to go back there.
Boonesboro's well, not that
it's
far.
One of the closer places we'll be looking to scavenge when we do.
It's yeah, like, it's know, a ton of 3,000 people.
Yeah, once you get out of Fort Drake, it's, you know, maybe like a 4 or 5 mile drive.
I'm looking for other places that may have, you know, the stuff we're looking for instead of, you know, just Frederick.
Yeah.
Well, I imagine hitting the towns would be...
It's a possibility.
Most reasonable thing. Yeah, Myersville, Boonesboro, St. James.
Frederick is the only, like, nearby city. Like, all those other places that are noted on the map around are, you know,
Shepherdstown is pretty close, but it's a little bit of a roundabout path.
It's also in West Virginia.
So what? At this point, the states don't really exist anymore, do they?
What's West Virginia good for besides coal, strip clubs, and gas stations?
What else does truck it need stops. To be good for? I'm sold.
There's truck stops there.
You had me at strip clubs.
I don't think strip clubs are open right now, but we could try.
Zombie strip club?
Strip clubs means strippers.
Zane looks, can I go?
Well, I think Shepherdstown is nearby, but I don't think it's... According to this, it's not very big.
No.
But it's far
it
enough away
look
from.
Very big, no.
But it's far enough away that it probably has its own school district. It probably has its own school district and maybe its own utilities because it's far enough away from the other big cities. That's the idea. So. Well, that's just
I'm
me
not,
with my.
I'm not sure what's to the left of it that might be like a huge town that would accommodate them.
Neither is the Zombie Master.
From my knowledge of the area, that's. I think it's like a couple of like 20 miles, and I think it's like not Charlottesville. There's a decently sized city. It's like 60,000 people, though, like 20 miles.
That is outside the nebulous confines of this current.
Yeah, so it doesn't really matter.
It doesn't exist.
Driving down the 480 there, and you just smash into a solid transparent wall.
What happens? We'll have to find out next time. Then we'd take a week and come back, and then you'd be able to continue down 480.
I think we can definitely just hit up these closer towns.
Yeah, we'll try
Middletown and Boonesboro. And Myersville, although it looks tiny.
Yeah, it's not a bad idea.
We never actually, and I know you, I think that was the session you missed, but we never really scavenged Boonesboro.
No.
We just holed up for the night and then left.
Jax will actually point that out, that you said you folks ran away from that, and if what Alfonso said was true, and Alfonso can confirm this, you know, they pretty much had to abandon much of what they had when they had their exodus leaving Boonesboro.
But at the same time, that was under pressure of a zombie horde, and if the horde kept moving and not many stayed behind, it might have just left a bunch of shit laying around.
Right, which is why it would be ideal to go look there. And considering the roads there are probably still okay, that would be a good idea to use the car.
Yeah, hop in.
Yeah, I've been advocating going and looting what's left of the the little fort up there for a while.
Yeah, we can go back up to Boonesboro, go to the old fort. You know, maybe we can find some clues about what actually happened here. Well, I mean, we got Alfonso, but hey, we can...
Maybe we can find some of the abandoned weapons and stuff as well.
Maybe.
Yeah, four people can fit inside that Japanese import, and I know four people who can go.
Do you?
I do. Sure.
I mean,
yeah, so, it's going to be me, Ray, Missy, and Samantha.
Didn't have time to install sunroof and mount the M249 on the roof.
Give me a week, okay?
You had a week.
Give me another week.
He needed the week to get the car working.
Seriously.
You guys can wait another week if you want.
Nope, we're taking the car. Right.
As if mounting it would make any of us any more capable with it.
I mean, you're still... As a matter of fact, the vehicle's going to be moving, so the penalty's even greater.
Okay, so the four of us, I'm assuming the four player characters are going to mount up, and we're going to drive this Japanese import on out of Fort Drake.
All right.
There we go.
Definitely
seatbelts. Yeah, the seatbelts do work, because this is a Japanese car.
This seems like a familiar situation somehow.
Where do you want to go first? We can go to Artesia really quickly, or we could...
Artesia is the closest. Take the north exit.
Wow.
Oh, God.
Crunch.
It just looks closer because we're going to airlift the car up to Boonesboro.
There you go. Yeah, I like that idea. Next.
Okay, if we're getting out of there like that, Pumman's going to stay in the back seat.
All right.
He knows what happens when people sit in the front seat in cars that Tony drives.
They have more fun.
Sure. Yeah, sure. Like more fortress tier.
All right, well, once you you close the distance, fairly quickly you can make it to Artesia. Artesia looks in the condition when it was where you left it.
Slightly shitty.
Yeah, and of course you guys have scavenged here before, and then there was a cult that scavenged here.
There's still water here, though.
And then you can... Yes, there is definitely the Artesian well. It still continues to flow, although the town circle roundabout area has seen better days. It used to be less burned once upon a time. The Artesian well still works. Because it's pretty hard to break an Artesian well.
Hmm. Well, you guys want to spend like a couple hours here looking around? See if there's anything we missed?
Not really.
Oh. Okay, well...
We already walked through it and there was nothing that stood out. I mean...
So, okay, I guess we're gonna take a left at Artesia and head up towards Boonesboro.
Alright. About a 4-mile trek, of course. The 10 miles just to get outside of Fort fucking Drake. Then, reaching Boonesboro, end up heading down the road. As has been the case with almost all of your driving excursions ever. It's been so long ago since you've driven! But in this case, the roads are still somewhat hazardous. You've got your debris, basically like the Oregon Trail, people like abandoning like their cast iron stoves or whatever that's weighing them down before they venture into the next leg of the Oregon Trail. The hope that their oxen will move faster.
Wow. These guys left behind 5 grandfather clocks.
Yeah.
Damn.
That will be the case. And eventually you end up coming across what is the city, or town, rather, of Boonesboro, or rather what it used to be. Of course, you spent some time in there once upon a time. You stuck to the northern area because the southwest area of it was completely walled off. With all of the mechanical monstrosity and basically all manner of, like, welded, like, car doors and cars themselves and whatever else that the cult could compile together to ensure their protection from the zombies. By and large, that's the skeleton of that as you're pulling in mid-afternoon. It's intact. There's definitely numerous decaying bodies surrounding the base of the fortifications, as well as dead on top of the fortifications. Fortifications themselves, as you're pulling in, and I imagine that would be the greatest point of interest since you have gone looking through some of those Boonesboro homes, and There was a cult, a group of people steadily scavenging from this area. So it would be a point of interest. The fort walls of the place do seem still to be fortified, like, shut. Although, as you four experienced, there are obviously, like, side passages where people could walk in and out. And you imagine that might have been how zombies broke in and how the people walked out. But you'd have to, like, open, like, the gates in order to get, like, the car in there.
Okay.
It's not too difficult, George. Just require you to take some time.
Can we hear anything moving around inside?
Well, you can certainly take some time to perception notice if you'd like.
I'm adding the plus two.
Perception notice. Whatcha?
See, acute hearing.
Right? And that's still taking the minus one, yes.
You're still taking the minus one. Anything mental.
Yeah, the plus two is already built into that rule.
Yeah.
That's impressive.
You. And Chris has no interest, it seems. All right. Fletch and Trusty Tony, they take some time to focus. They hear nothing but the gentle breeze swaying the, the shutters and dilapidated houses, as well as rustling all of the mechanical, debris, the metal that's been welded together. So they certainly hear a wide variety of sounds, maybe wind chimes in the back, but they don't hear anything like a person or animal moving.
And nothing that sounds deliberate.
Yes, nothing which sounds deliberate. I like that.
Well, I still think we should sneak in one of the sideways, or maybe even the way we went out, just in case.
Sure. Sounds like a good idea.
Get our sneak on.
Get our sneaky on.
Sounds like a plan.
All right. In that case, if you folks are gonna make your sneak on, then I want to see some sneaky rolls.
Oh god, I'm back. Sorry about that. Internet.
It's fine. It's fine. Not a problem, Chris. We will say that Kat can stay with the vehicle if she likes, rather than make a sneaky roll.
Yeah, she's at best gonna just be there to help move them out.
Okay. Well, Trusty Tony and Fletch are got a handle on the sneaking business. Trusty Tony has learned from the best how to sneak, even when a pool is not involved. Potman, on the other hand, seems to find a tendency to step on, like, loose welded metal, just like bits of, like, car or whatever that ends up being in his way, particularly when you walk through, like, one of the side avenues to try to walk into the base. He definitely makes enough noise to make his step sound deliberate.
This is just not his day.
That minus one. No, he didn't even have a minus one.
Because it's not mental. Right.
It's the thought of the minus one. That being said, it does not sound, at least to Fletch and Trusty Tony, that anything deliberately responds to Potman's lack of finesse. And the three of you do end up making your way into the enclosed area, where you do see many other dead bodies, some with weapons on them, carrying, like, still spread out around the ground. It appears, at least on this glance, that those who do still have their weapons with them, bodies that are on the ground, appear to have committed suicide and deliberately targeted their heads, either with knives, which is pretty...
That's pretty brutal.
It's pretty severe to fucking take a knife and stab that, like, under your chin.
That's pretty metal, man.
Well, they, cultists, yes, pretty so metal. Or using guns, perhaps due to their injuries, and it seems as if those bodies may have sustained injuries that they were not willing to turn into zombies.
Are there zombie bodies inside the compound?
There are definitely some bodies that are rougher than others, but after all these weeks that have passed since you've been here, you are barely able to glean any information, more than what I've already said.
Well, I mean, like, are there a lot of bodies inside, or just some?
I don't know. Maybe out there in the immediate area, maybe 18?
Hmm.
18. 18's a good number. 18 that have weapons with them. And maybe 3-4 dozen more that don't have
weapons. I meant zombie bodies.
Right, but it's impossible to tell after it's been over a month since these people have died laying here.
I've never watched bodies rot, so okay.
Yeah.
Should try. It's actually really interesting.
With that in mind, there's 18 who have weapons, melee and ranged, and then there's 3-4 dozen bodies that don't have weapons by them.
Are there any buildings that look barricaded, like somebody might still be there?
Well, you don't hear anything deliberate, but all of the buildings that are interior here, including the jail, have had, like, barricade work done to them, and they also appear to have suffered exterior and interior damage.
What do you guys think? Clear the area, make sure it's safe, and then start scavenging?
Sounds about right.
Yeah, I'll try to be helpful.
Well, we might end up in close quarters combat.
Do you have a knife I could borrow?
I do. If you really don't want to risk it, if you took a hiding spot out here where you could just alert us if something happens.
Yeah, that's the bitch way out.
Okay. I'll hand him the large knife kukri.
And Trusty Twain drops it on his foot and dies.
I would be impressed if it did that much damage from falling on your foot.
Yeah, well, he's like,
I might have to start using it again.
She's recklessly dropped it.
All right, Trusty Tony is looks ungangly, gangly. He doesn't look
sure.
Yes, he doesn't. He looks ungainly with the kukri in his hands. Just put it that way. Yeah. Okay, let's take this nice and slow. And oh God, what's that? Oh, it's nothing.
Carry on. Nothing to see here.
Do we encounter anything as we move from building to building, making sure it's all clear?
Yeah.
Why don't you three give me dexterity plus stealth checks again?
You get a bullet in the face!
Damn it!
Alright, well, now it's Trusty Tony. Perhaps with his knife in hand, he has been so incredibly empowered that he is willing to succeed in all manner of ventures. Right. Three of you slowly begin the process of checking to make sure whether everything is clear. Let me go ahead and...
At the same time, I assume we're taking note of what's in each building.
Sure. You've got a smattering of houses. The only thing that particularly stands out is a jail. Go ahead and make that roll.
Jay.
Sorry about that. All right. God damn it. Quit dying. Bad. No more dying.
But if you die, we won't get our experience for the night.
Fucking experience points. Shit. Alright. Houses, show, like, all manners of, death associated with them. You've got, ruin. Obviously, signs of people might have tried to further barricade themselves in there. In your casual sweeps, you're not ending up finding, anyone who's alive. You're just taking a quick inventory of things, like, alright, this was a house... Alright, doesn't look like anyone's moving around in here. And to go to like another house, continue a slow sweep, as quiet as you folks are, except for Trusty Tony, who does seem like that he is the one who's making deliberate sounds. Anything hearable then? All right. And end up continuing. Let me go ahead and make another roll for the situation. All right. So it'll be enough. Ends up being where you approach the jail.